one of the icons, I think, of this industry, who really, in part, helped to create this industry. I mean, one of the reasons that you all are listening to me right now and that I even have this job and I even get a paycheck for this job is because of this man who is joining me now via Skype. And I am so privileged to have him on my show, Mr. James Golden, who people might popularly know as the one and only Bo Snerdley, the official radio observer for the Rush Limbaugh program, God rest his soul. And Mr. Golden joins us now. And it is such a pleasure to have you on with me today. And congratulations on the book, because I'm so excited for you on this. But just welcome. This is surreal. This is a very surreal moment for me.
I'm looking for Mr. Golden here, Dana, James, or Bo. How are you?
I'm doing so well. I'm great now that you're here. I'm fantastic. But I, you have this.
You know, Dana, as you know, I.
Go ahead. Sorry.
I've told you how much I admire you, how much I admire you, how much this audience that you have is so lucky to have your voice. You are a symbol of courage in our industry. Like Rush Limbaugh, Dana, you stand up for what you believe. You have taken so many unfair, scurrilous, mean-spirited hits, and yet you stay with such good humor, such optimism. I love you. I think you are remarkable, and the talk radio industry could not have a better champion for us at this time than you, Dana.
Well, I don't think that anybody could ever leave me speechless, but you just did. My goodness. I thank you for that. And I am such a huge fan of yours. And I remember when I would hear a Mr. Snerdley referred to on air, and I always thought, I want to meet him. And there was a long time that we thought he was just making somebody up. Nobody actually thought that you were an actual person in there with him. And then I read this article. I think it was, I don't remember if it was New York Times or where I read it. It was a profile piece on Rush Limbaugh. And you were not only real, you were there. You're an icon in this industry. And you have this book out, Rush on the Radio, a tribute from his sidekick for 30 years. I'm curious as to what you think today about commentary and the state of politics, because I think it's incredibly fair to say that you actually helped create this industry and with Rush Limbaugh helped shape what punditry and commentary and analysis is today. What do you think about the state of things?
I couldn't be more optimistic, and that may come as a surprise to people. I'm very optimistic about the state of things. Yeah, I know what Joe Biden is doing to the country. We all can see it. But Dana, America is a young country. I mean, we are still so young on the world stage, and we've been going through this back and forth with socialists and with liberals ever since this country was founded. It is not a new battle. We have new ways of expression in the battle, but we also have an America that still stands despite all the dings, all the nicks. We have an America that still stands as the beacon of light in this world. We have more people that want to come here. I mean, for instance, in Virginia, you look at a Winsome Sears victory, and I paid attention on election night. She talked about it in his pocket. And now she found her space in the United States military. And today, as a first generation immigrant to this country, she is Lieutenant Governor of the state of Virginia. American dream is still alive if people want to go out and achieve it.
I love that. If people want to go out and achieve it, that dream is still there. They can still go out and achieve it. We're talking to none other than Bo Snerdley, a.k.a. James Golden. I don't have to say James Golden, a.k.a. Bo Snerdley, or Bo Snerdley, a.k.a. James Golden, because you're both now, and you're still your radio programming icon. And you started in music. You're doing an afternoon drive time program. I know you got your new book out, Rush on the Radio, tribute from his sidekick for 30 years. And folks, you can follow him, and I suggest you do, because he gets some great stuff, at Bo Snerdley. The state of things, everyone always says that I think politics has always kind of been nasty. And people, I think, need to be reminded from time to time that they need to continue to be happy warriors. And that is the one thing that I think that I learned from you. I saw that message reinforced with you. I saw it with Rush. And I think that's one of the things that you all helped bring to politics, because you can have fun while explaining why people are wrong to think the way they do. And you can have a good time doing it. And it's so important to be a happy warrior, and you can't let this stuff get you down. How did you get that perspective? How did you get to have that perspective in this industry?
Well, look, first of all, you love to love what you do, because if you love what you do, then you transmit that to people. If that's what's inside of you, then that's what's going to come out, and that's what you're going to project. I love radio. I've loved radio since I was 14 years old. Rush started at age 6 in his house. First radio show on a Remco a toy, broadcast to an audience of one, his mother, right? And so at age 6, started honing his skills, writing scripts. When you love something, you have fun doing it. And to me, now, that's not to say that it's all, you know, I'm not looking at things through a rose-colored glass. I mean, I've had days where you have, you know, bad people do bad things and all of that. That's part of life. But if you stay with your passion and what you love, it's easy to be happy about it and feel blessed and know that no matter what happens, if you're doing your best and you're striving for excellence and you're really giving it all you've got, it's easy to be happy. It is not easy to be happy looking at some things in the country. We don't want to see people suffering the way they're suffering. It's not just economic suffering with inflation. There's some real challenges we have. There are people out here that are victims of horrible crime because of policies that are reckless and dangerous. We have people that are suffering from economic policies that have shut down their business in these past 2 years, things they've worked all their lives for. And so, yes, we see the inequities in life. We see the hardships in life. We see what people are going through in life. But it doesn't mean that you yourself have to give in and be negative. We're about trying to change people's lives and help people change their own lives for the better. And so I think it's just incumbent upon us to try to be filled with gratitude. We live in the greatest nation that the humanity has ever witnessed. We have so much to be grateful for. And so in spite of everything that goes wrong, in spite of all of the troubled times, in spite of all of it, we can still try to maintain a spirit of optimism as we move through our lives.
I love that. Talking with Bo Snerdley, a.k.a. James Golden. He's got an afternoon drive time radio program on WABC in New York. And his book released just at the end of last month, Rush on the Radio, a tribute from his sidekick for over 30 years. You can get it where books are sold, also at Barnes & Noble everywhere. People need to buy from Barnes & Noble, because that actually makes it hit more on New York Times bestseller list, as opposed if you order it, like if you go to Walmart, which is always crazy to me. JamesGolden.com is the website as well. What do you prefer people call you, Bo or James? I'm curious.
Doesn't matter. 30 years is Bo. 30 years is Bo. I've kind of gotten used to it. And all my life is James. Well, I'm really used to that one. So.
Yeah. Tell me how the Snerdley, I know you talk about all of this and you get into, you know, your relationship with Rush and radio, but out of all the names, Snerdley is just, there is no name that you can compare that to. How'd you get that? We have a little bit of a delay here.
Well, first, let me start with this bold thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So here's what happened. So there were always Snerdleys with the Rush Show, but no one remembers the other ones because I was there for so long. There was Marva Snerdley and Mervyn Snerdley, right? Marva was a liberal. And so when Rush first came to New York and was syndicated, she didn't want her liberal New York buddies to know that she worked on a conservative show. So he called her Marva Snerdley. She didn't last long. Then came Mervyn Snerdley. Now, Mervyn wasn't a liberal, but Mervyn didn't last long either. And once I rotated onto the show, that was the arrangement with WABC, our flagship station, that WABC would provide the call screener and the engineer. So I was rotated on the show. I was the senior producer at ABC. Before that, I was the music director at ABC. So I walked out of one studio, produced their last music show, walked into another studio and produced their first talk show. I was rotated on the show, and of course, Rush and I clicked. Now, even before the show, I was, you know, giving stories to Rush that I thought he might be interested in, as were many of us there. And Rush was friendly. We all loved Rush from the very beginning. Let me tell you, he was just so wonderful a human being. You could not help but love this man if you knew him. And that's why I think it hurts the heart a little bit when people who don't know him try to tell people who he is. They have no clue who he is, right? But also, you know, from the very first time that Rush started doing the show, anybody that knew radio knew this was something different. He had a unique skill set. He had a unique way of expression, of a very, very sharp sense of satire and humor that no one else could emulate. He was just the consummate professional when he walked in there. And for 27, the show grew for 33 years. I think we ended up with 27 million listeners when he died. But that's almost unheard of, a 30-year growth track on a radio program.
Yeah. That's you don't hear, yeah, hear stuff like that. You don't hear stuff like that. I have to tell you, I would listen when I was younger, and I was raised, you know, I was raised all by very, very far left Democrats. And I would listen every now and then. I'd catch it on the radio, and I think this man is so wrong. Can't exactly say why, but he's wrong, and I know it. And then as I got older, I'm like, okay, he's making sense now. He's starting to make some sense to me. I get it. And then I'd be like, he really knows what he's talking about. Why haven't I listened to him longer than this? Because he really knows his stuff. It's just, you all raised a lot of people. The Rush Limbaugh program, I think, actually raised people into grown adults and educated them, which, and as you were saying, you know, over 30 years of doing this, there's nothing, I don't know, there's nothing in broadcast that you can compare that to. Not even Johnny Carson.
Yeah, it was remarkable. And in the beginning, you know, Rush didn't like to take vacations either. Mm-hmm. I mean, he was so, I mean, we were there. And the thing about that, though, is Rush loved what he loved what he did from beginning to end. I imagine myself getting a death sentence. And look, I walked into a radio station when I was 14 years old, fell in love with it, knew I wanted to be in radio, right? So I am passionate about this business. I love radio as well. I get a death sentence. Bye-bye. It's been a great career, and I'm great. I'm going to go see some things in the world I haven't seen yet. Rush's bucket list was his audience. Oh. Every day. Oh. Every day that this man was not in treatment or dealing with the after effects of that treatment, he was at work. And he came into work just as prepared as he always was. I spent hours preparing to be there. His show was flawless. The energy level was flawless. You couldn't tell anything was wrong. At the end of the show, the three of us that were in the room across from him, our stenographer, Dawn Baczynski, our Florida engineer, Brian Johnson, and myself, we could see what those shows had taken out of him, because there were days where he could barely get out of his seat. There were days that he had to have someone come in and lift his attaché case because he didn't even have the energy to do that. It drained him to do those shows. But every single day that he could be there, up until the last show, he was there, and his performance was flawless.
Talking with our wonderful friend, Bo Snerdley, James Golden, Rush on the Radio, a tribute to his sidekick for 30 years. And I think I have to say, that's a professional mark that I think so many people in broadcasting try to attain. I mean, that is, everyone always says hashtag goals, but man, that it really is. It's goals. It's goals for not just how to do a show, but what you said is so important, how his audience was his bucket list. That's amazing. And that's really, ultimately, I've never heard a better description. I've never heard a better goal ever described as to how a broadcaster should be with their audience. And you're still, you know, I mean, it's still educating people, and you're carrying that legacy on, my friend. You are. Yeah. And I have to tell you, thank you for the encouragement, because you were one of the very first people when I first got started into radio. You said something nice to me online one day. It was nice. Appreciate that. I don't mean to, you're making me emotional. You're crying and I'm crying. This is not how radio's supposed to go. Not how it's supposed to be. But I have to say, you have encouraged so many people out there. So thank you for that. I really appreciate that. Thank you.
You're welcome. And you, like I said, I've been following you from the beginning. You know, your career. Wow. Wow. And we're all proud of you. We are so proud of you. And, you know, one of the things that makes us most proud is that, Dana, we know who the people are that have always ceaselessly attacked you. Yeah. And we've been through it. You're going through it. The next generation of broadcasters will go through it because they're relentless.
Yep.
But you have never, ever lowered yourself to become mean and nasty like these people have.
I get tempted. And I tried. I there's some days when I feel like I fall short, but I try every day.
No, that's the best we all can do.
Right.
And so it's pretty remarkable. And you're going to have a very long career ahead, God willing. Hopefully everything goes right. You'll be at a 30 or 35, 40 year mark in this business one day too. And you'll be encouraging the next generation of conservative talk radio hosts.
As it should be, passing that torch, passing that baton on, because somebody's, you know, when we want to retire, you know, somebody's got to do this. Somebody's got to get out there and talk to people. We want to take a break at some point and be able to do that. Bo Snerdley, James Golden, the book is Rush on the Radio, a tribute from his sidekick for 30 years. And I have to say, of all the years that I have been, well, I act like I've been on a little over 10 years, and I'm sitting here acting like it's been 1,000 years I've been on air. But I have never, ever teared up on air until you join me on air. It's the first time ever in any professional capacity. And my producer's going, yes, I've never seen this. This is so weird right now. So you I'm glad it was in a conversation with you. Bo Snerdley, James Golden, just truly an American icon. Thank you so much for bringing that program with Rush Limbaugh every day on air, and also for continuing to do it and for educating the next generation. God bless you, my friend. We'd love to have you back.
Anytime, Dana. God bless you, and thank you so much. It is an honor to be with you.
Thank you. An honor to be with you, my friend.